We know in your presence there is fullness of joy. That's where we want to be. Draw us nearer to you. Away from challenges and the turmoil and the issues of these times. Father, draw us closer to you. Thank you, precious King. For in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Friends, thank God it is Saturday. I hope you enjoy yourself yesterday at wonderful prayer time, wonderful word at the Holy Ghost service. And I know that this year, God is God and He will be glorified. Today we want to talk about in Christ alone. And that's why you heard my wife singing, drumming there. It takes you to be in God, with God, and for God, for a lot of things to happen. We are in a time and season where issues, people hate you for no reason. People just want your downfall. People sell their brothers, sell their parents. The other day, they said four guests went somewhere in a taxi cab and they went to sell one of them to ritual killers. And the taxi man saw them with plenty of money. The taxi man asked them, "Where's your fourth friend?" He said, "Don't worry, just go. What's your concern?" So the man had to stop at a police checkpoint and told the police people, he said, "See, I carried these girls, there were four, but four went in, three came out with a lot of money. I don't know where the other one is." Then the police people, they pick up the matter and they went back to where they went to sell the girl. Guess what, friends? It was too late. They've already killed the girl and it was a terrible situation. So friends, times like this, you need God. In times like this that you can't even tell who is who. People are betraying each other. No wonder the Bible says the last days, perilous times shall come. We're in a perilous time, and that's why you need Christ alone. The Bible records concerning Samson in Judges chapter 16. If you read all through from verse 14, the Bible, but I want to zero in on verse 20. This is a lady that Samson wanted to marry. This is a lady that Samson invested himself with. And the lady kept asking him, "What's the secret of your power?" And Samson kept saying it until Samson told her the truth. And she took advantage of Samson. And she told Samson, "Samson, your enemies come upon you." But see, where I'm going today is that Samson thought it's about him. He didn't know it was about God. Samson said, "Oh, I will rise again like before." But the Bible says the spirit of, let me read that part, verse 20. Then she cried out, "Samson, the Philistines have come to capture you." When he woke up, he thought, "I will do as before and shake myself free." But he didn't realize the Lord had left him. May God not leave you this year. May God not leave you this year. May God not leave you this year. Friend, Samson thought it was about him. He didn't know it was God. In Acts chapter 19, if you read from verse 11 all through, you see the story of some people that think it's about just calling the name of Jesus. And when they saw that God was doing special miracles through the hands of Paul, they didn't know that Paul had submitted himself to Jesus. Paul knew that it's about God. That's why the Bible recorded it that way. God did special miracles. It wasn't Paul doing the miracles, God doing it through him. You know, the Lord Jesus Christ told us in John chapter 15 and verse 5, He said, "Without me, you can do nothing." Friends, you will wither if you separate yourself from Him. If you read from verse 2, He said, if you are fruitful, my Father will prune you. He said, but if you are outside me, He said, as a branch from me, if you are outside me, you will dry up. Haven't you noticed when you cut a branch from a tree? It won't grow, it will dry up. But it was doing well when it was attached to the tree. Get yourself attached to God this year. Because in Him, you will succeed. In Him, you will find help. Beloved brethren, I want to encourage you. Don't disconnect yourself from God. You need Him. If God is on your side, you have all that you need. And I pray for you that Christ will come true for you in Jesus' name. Remember, friends, tomorrow it is another wonderful time in God's presence. And I invite you to come. We started the program yesterday evening, a prayer meeting, and we are concluding it today in our church. Our ministry is a regional evangelist, a regional pastor, Ezekiel, Ayola. We invite you to join us. It's going to be a wonderful time in God's presence. God bless you. God bless you. Wonderful, wonderful.